Hello everybody, I am the Mademoiselle and this is my channel, and Jodia, we are going to be reacting to a white mother telling us how to do a black girl's hair.
Before we get into this video, please make sure you go check out my sponsor, Ebony Life. Ebony Life is a black woman discussion app where we can go and discuss all of our problems, okay? It was made just for us. It is a safe space so that we can express how we feel whenever we want. If you want more details, go down in the description or in my pinned comment down below. Make yourself an account and get started today.
Now, this is not what you think, okay? A lot of you guys have forwarded me videos from this channel. The name of this woman is Christy Gior. From what I gathered, from what I looked at from some of her videos, she's adopted black children and she's embarked on the journey on how to take care of their hair, and particularly her black daughter. I get a lot of videos sent to me about white women doing hair or like braids or ethnic hairstyles being done on white women, and that's for a whole nother video. Today we're gonna focus on Christy Gior and other white parents who adopt black kids. So I know there's a lot of people who genuinely do not like the idea of white people adopting black kids. And personally, I feel like there's so many kids in the system, especially black kids, that it should not matter who adopts them as long as they are able to love them, give them what they need, provide for them, protect them, and support them. I feel like skin color should not matter when it comes to being a good parent. However, I do believe that it does kind of like counterintuitive to be adopted by someone who's not the same race or ethnicity as you, because you may lose that part of your culture. However, I feel like, again, it's more important to be loved, supported, taken in by a family that truly, you know, cares about you. And you can always learn your culture via yourself, or your family can learn your culture. In this case, I love the fact that she is literally trying to raise her kids the best way she can. And part of her raising her kids, and in particularly her daughter in this case, is that she took the effort to learn how to do her hair and do her hair well so that it doesn't break off, that she retains length and it stays moisturized. Like, I was watching this video, I didn't really watch the whole thing because I wanted to react to it. I skipped through it and I believe I left a comment and I was like, you know what, I have to circle back to this and watch it with you guys to see exactly what she's saying and exactly what she's doing. I think it's just so beautiful. Like, I love this. And for all of the white parents out there, or other parents who adopt kids that aren't their own race or ethnicity, we need these people. We do not understand how people will be so upset about this, because at the end of the day, it is more important that the kid is being adopted and the kid is being loved, supported, and all of that, not in danger, and they're not sitting in the system with no one to love them. I feel like it's very, very important to acknowledge that there's people out there that are willing to adopt any kid, even if they are not the same color, race, or ethnicity as them. Like, it really bothers me and it grinds my gears, because the people that will complain about this will be the same people who won't go out and adopt children, or the people who can't even qualify to adopt a child. So it's just like, if you're not gonna adopt them, who the fuck is? And it's just like, people just focus on the wrong thing. I saw a lot of comments about like people saying, oh, you know, she's doing it wrong, or she's pulling the kid's hair and the kid is in pain and all of this extra shit. And it's like, at least she's fucking trying, because if she wasn't trying, I'm sure a lot of people would have a lot of bullshit to say too. If she was sitting there relaxing her hair or putting a wig on the kid's hair or putting weave in the kid's hair for absolutely no reason, I'm sure a lot of you guys would have a lot of shit to say. I feel like a lot of people are just very, very negative and have nothing else to do, and they just want to say shit to say shit, and that's not okay. I'm fully aware that there's been some very wild cases of white people adopting black kids and not treating them right, okay? There's been a good chunk. However, I believe, as with anything, that a few bad apples should not spoil the bunch. Just like they look at us some type of way sometimes, doesn't mean we need to be like, oh my God, all white people are like this. Or just like, you know, they might be like, oh, these black people, this, that, and the third. I don't think that anyone should look at anyone and be like, oh my God, well, y'all Indians be doing this, y'all black people be doing that, y'all Asians be doing that. I just don't think that's okay. I think that's really, really fucked up across the board. I don't care. I'm tired of black people thinking they can't be racist. Y'all can be racist. Anyone can be racist. It may be powerless, it may not affect you, but you can still hurt someone's feelings. You can really put down someone else's race and make them feel less than, okay? I understand that black people being racist doesn't really change anything, but it's still being racist because you're making someone feel bad about where they come from, about who they are. So I said what the fuck I said. You can leave your comment down below. I'm gonna ignore it, waste your time if you want to. I'm not gonna tolerate anyone coming on here and bashing this woman because I feel like she's doing a really excellent job at raising her children. And I also feel like it takes a lot and it takes a very, very special person to do what she's doing, especially learning ethnic hair and learning how to take care of it for her daughter's sake. Comment down below, are you adopted? And were you adopted by someone who was the same race or ethnicity as you? How was it? Was it great? Was it bad? Did anyone take the initiative to try to teach you your culture, your background? Or did anyone try to like change you to be like their culture? Like, I would like to know, because I've heard a lot of people say a lot of good things and I've heard a lot of people say a lot of bad things. So I'm going to link the three videos that I saw pertaining to her doing her daughter's hair. But today we're going to react to her most viewed one. And it is called The Basic African American Kids Hair Care Routine Plus Tips for Foster and Adoptive Moms. So this is a pretty long video. You can go and watch the full video down in the description box below or in the pinned comment, because I'm probably going to cut a lot of it out. Hi everyone, my name is Christy and this is my beautiful daughter, India. This is not a hair tutorial. This is simply a video that I wanted to get out there to any other mamas of beautiful African American children with gorgeous hair that needs to be maintained. I'm hoping that there are some foster mamas, some adoptive mamas, or any other type of ethnicity or nationality or whatever you want to call it that do not have experience caring for African American children's hair. I have been there, I have learned, I am no way an expert. I am learning something new every single day, but I really wish there was a video out there that I could have used in my beginning stages of my learning of caring for my daughter's hair. I'm gonna be Christy, so I'm sorry. There's literally hundreds, if not thousands, of videos on how to care for African American or black or ethnic, however you want to, whatever term you want to use, hair on YouTube. I don't know where she personally went to go learn or where she personally looked the first time. But I beg to differ. It's very interesting that she said that. I'm like, why would you not check YouTube first? Okay, whatever. Let's just keep watching.
Totally real and transparent. My two older daughters, Avea and Elia, their hair requires a lot more attention than my younger daughters, Natalia and Lily. Like, I'm just going to be completely real and put it all out there. But I have learned that it is their crown. It is their identity. It is what they look in the mirror every single day and then they see and they're proud of. It is a part of who they are.
She has beautiful hair.
For that reason, it was so incredibly important for me to learn how to care for their hair properly. Every single coil, every single strand of their hair needs to be gently cared for appropriately to what their hair specifically needs. My daughter Avea has a completely different texture than my daughter Elia. They require different products, different styles, different routines, and different care. I know that sounds super overwhelming, and you're right. Sometimes it is. I'm gonna be completely honest with you. Sometimes it takes me 2 to 3 hours to wash, dry, moisturize, detangle, and put it in a protective style. But I love it. It's a bonding time. It's something that is super important to them, just as much as it's important to me. I am their mama.
I love the fact that she said that doing her daughter's hair is like bonding time, because I see a lot of black mothers in particular who get very frustrated with their daughter's hair, and instead of actually using it as a bonding time or a time to learn what really works for their kid's hair, they go and they perm it, they put some, you know, relaxer in it, they texturize it, they, you know, throw some weave in it or whatever the case may be, instead of actually doing the kid's hair by themselves. You know, so I really like that she's using it as a bonding moment, and I think that's something a lot of us need to do. Instead of getting frustrated with her kid's hair because you don't know what the fuck to do with it, we need to spend the time to actually, like, do it and actually learn and actually use it to bond. Like, I know a lot of us growing up hated doing our hair. I hated doing my hair. And a lot of people hated their hair doing their hair because they were tender-headed. I was never tender-headed. I just didn't like to sit still. And I hated the fact that it would take away from me watching fucking TV, especially when I had to turn certain angles so my mom could do certain parts of my hair. So I just hated it. And, you know, I feel like a lot of people don't seek certain things when it comes to like what can make their child more comfortable with the experience. I feel like a lot of people just, oh my god, you're being tender-headed, and you know, they're hitting the kid, they're yanking the kid, they're doing all this extra shit. Like, my mom used to really piss me off with that shit. Like, she would just yell at me, just like, nigga, like, I just don't want to be here. Like, so I feel like people should just be, you know, trying to, I feel like a lot of moms, and this is not even just black moms, like a lot of moms, like when you're doing your daughter's hair and your daughter doesn't like it, try to divert her attention to something else or use it as another thing that is more positive, make it a more positive experience.
It is my job to make sure that they are cared for financially, okay, physically, mentally, and as well as their hygiene. And actually, this is all about their confidence and how they approach the world as well.
This is true.
This seems like a lot to you guys, but I promise you, I'm speaking truth here. Like,
she is.
Your hair is so important for you guys to learn to maintain. And if you feel like it's too much, and you've tried, and you've watched YouTube videos, and you just can't get it down, I really encourage you to seek help. You know, Google it, Yelp it. There's gotta be someone out there that can help
that is
you.
True.
Care for your child's hair, whether it be your own biological child,
yeah,
your foster child,
yep,
or your adoptive child.
She definitely has
if
point.
If you find that it's too difficult to maintain, please find someone that can help you. And again, I am not an expert. I am not a hairstylist. I'm simply some regular mama from around the block that has learned and is still learning to
she
care
from around the block.
Her kid's hair. Like, I can't say this enough. I am not an expert. This is not a hair tutorial. I'm just simply doing my baby girl's hair and talking to you guys.
This is really cute.
That being said, I am going to share some of the things that I really wish I learned early on. These are just super, super basic hair care things. First of all, be gentle with their hair.
That is true.
It is prone to breakage a million times more than Caucasian or Asian hair, or
this
Indian hair, or whatever else is out there.
She right.
I can't stress this enough. Please be gentle with their hair. Do not wash it every single week. You're stripping the oils that they really do not have enough of, as I would. So please do not wash their hair more than once a week. And if you do wash it, please lather on that conditioner, let it sit, gently massage it in, and let the hair soak it up before you rinse it out.
Mm-hmm.
Then afterwards, put some leave-in conditioner in it,
okay,
every single time you wash or co-wash. It's super important to just automatically bring back that moisture in as much as possible, because washing strips all the natural oils out of the hair. I love coconut oil. Coconut oil is amazing. I really suggest you put coconut oil on the scalp every single day if you can. Put it in a spray bottle, put it on their edges, and the creases, not the creases, what are they called? The parts in their
oh
hair.
Oh, God, that's funny.
And just,
all right, the coconut oil thing. That shit broke my hair off, and I know a lot of people who say that they have, like, a coconut oil sensitivity as well. Coconut milk doesn't really bother my hair, but coconut oil, like, will split the fuck out of my ends, and I was so upset because, like, I was using it for a whole year, and it fucked my hair up. However, I know there's a lot of people that do benefit from it, and I know people are going to be, like, quick to comment about it, like, oh, my God, no, coconut oil is horrible. I don't think it's horrible. I feel like it depends on who you are, and I think that most of these tips, it depends on who you are. Everyone's hair is different, especially when it comes to ethnic hair. Completely different. Everyone's hair is like, what may work for me may not work for you. What works for this little girl may not work for you or me. So please be respectful, okay? Because I already saw some ignorant comments, and I'm just like, are y'all dead ass right now? Like, okay.
Gently put your fingers through it and keep that scalp moisturized.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you'll see grease and such in the stores and such. And yes, I do use that sometimes, but I really strongly suggest you do not put it on the scalp because it clogs the pores.
I grease my scalp and I swear by it.
Like I said, try not to wash the hair so much, but if you feel like every 3 to 4 days you like you need to, just do a co-wash. Just do a simple wash with conditioner only, or dilute the shampoo a lot with some water if you feel like you really must. But don't forget, put that leave-in conditioner in right away. and gently detangle it with a wide tooth comb.
This girl has beautiful hair.
Proper detangling brush while the conditioner is still in it, while they're still in the bathtub or the shower or laid up on the counter, whatever. Gently do it there, so it just makes the detangling process a lot easier. As far as shampoos, please do not use anything with silicones or sulfates. It dries out their hair at a more rapid rate. And also, please do not use any heat in their hair when they're this young. I mean, some people do, and to each their own, but it's really not good. It's just speeds up the damaging process. And she's beautiful. She just, these cute little natural styles is all this little baby girl needs.
And okay, the thing with the sulfates, I swear by sulfates. I've been using them my whole life. I know they're not good for you necessarily and they dry your hair out, but for me, I haven't seen a difference with sulfates versus non-sulfates for my hair, but I can understand why people would want to stay away from them. As far as the heat situation, I don't usually put heat in my hair at all. That shit dries your hair the fuck out for real. Like, it's so annoying because it's like you sit there, you moisturize your hair, or some people blow dry then moisturize, whatever the case may be, and it's just like, bro, your hair be dead as fuck. Like, I rarely ever blow dry my hair. But some people's hair can withstand heat really, really well. And there's also heat protectant as well. Personally, I don't know. I'm not as anal with the heat thing. I just don't really feel the need to. Like, I always air dry my hair. I don't even towel dry. I don't t-shirt dry. I air dry it. Like, when I wash my hair, I'll put it in, like, 4 little rolls. Or I'll leave it in a puff. And I just let it dry throughout the day. Like, I do not, like, blow dry my hair like that. Unless, like, I have to. Like, I just washed my hair, but I'm about to go get it done. And I don't want it to be wet or whatever. But yeah, I know a lot of people whose hair can withstand the heat really, really well. But yeah, I'm good, love. Like, but some people's hair were really burnt to a motherfucking crisp. So comment down below. Do you have, like, do you use a blow dryer? Like, I have blow dryers. I just don't really use them. How often do you use them? Do you use them every single time you wash your hair? Because I'm very, very curious.
Another thing that I learned, not early on, but later on, a couple years into having my daughters, is that tight ponytails, tight braids
can look
pretty cool, but they put a lot of stress on hair and scalp. Over time, they can create crimps and breakage in hair.
That's not even just black people's hair, that's everyone's hair.
And cause thinning along the hairline, which I've been there, I've gone through it, trial and error. I'm learning something new every single day. Rubber bands are super damaging, but you'll see about 3 or 4 sections of Ilya's hair today. I am using the rubber bands, but I'm only using them lightly. They're not tight, and I know they're in sections that are super healthy and moisturized, and it will not break her hair. But my recommendation is just to try not to use rubber bands at all. They can cause tears and breakage, and that is not good. This is probably the most important one that I want to talk to you guys about, is the use of relaxers in kids' hairs.
Oh, child.
I have seen so many mamas that do not want to deal with the hair. And I know it's a lot of work and you feel like it's a burden.
Oh, child,
you don't have time. You don't have the patience. But please don't put relaxers in your child's hair. It's not good. It damages it. And I've seen so many of my friends grow up and are constantly trying to grow their hair back and nurture it because their parents put relaxers in it when they were kids. Also,
preach! 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 Like, it's crazy that I still see little kids with relaxers in their hair. Like, I be shook. And these mothers don't be having no shame. Like, granted, you do what you want with your kid, okay? You do what you want with your kid. But it's like, that shit's not even good for adults. Imagine what it does to a child's scalp. Like, I've just never been okay with it. Like, it's one thing if the kid's a little older, whatever, do what you do. But, like, a kid, like, a legit child, it's just not okay. Stop being lazy. No one told you to have a kid that you didn't want to fucking do their hair for. Like, no one told you to have a kid that you didn't want to fully take care of. That means hair. That means everything, okay? Emotionally, financially, like she said, it means everything. Their hair is part of that. Why have a kid if you're not going to put 100% into taking care of them? Like, I don't get it. Like, relaxing their kid's hair just always has grinded my gears. Because it's like, why would you go through all of this shit to, like, grow the kid's hair, you know, or your kid has really nice, healthy hair, and then you go and you relax it? And it's crazy because it's like, I kid you not, comment down below if you've ever had a relaxer and you realize how hard it was to grow your hair after that. Like, it's very difficult after that to grow your hair. Like, it's hard to bounce back from a relaxer. So it's just like, you're setting up your kid for failure in the long run, to be quite honest. Unless they're just going to stick to relaxers for the rest of their life. But it's just ridiculous. I like the tips that she's given. I really do. back to the rubber band thing. My mom always used rubber bands in my hair, always. And it always seemed to make my hair grow really, really fast. I don't know what it was, but she never used it at the end. She always used it at my scalp. Like she would part, like, you see the hairstyle she's doing? My mom would do that, but she would use the rubber bands to section. So she would section, rubber band, then braid. And then she would just leave them like that. Like she would never do anything on the ends. No barrettes, no nothing. She would just twist my hair and leave it like that. It used to be cute. That was my signature little hairstyle. My mom's never put rubber bands at the ends of my hair. The only person that used to do that was my best friend's mom. When she would do my hair, she would put rubber bands at the end of my hair to secure the beads. But that's about it. Comment down below. Do you do your kids' hair with rubber bands and beads still? I haven't seen that in a while. Like these beads, I'm just like, whoa, that's nostalgia. I love it. I think it's just so cute on children.
So every now and then, just let the hair go. Let it go. Put it down. Put it in a loose bun or ponytail.
Nope.
Put a super cute headband on her. There's some really cute ones I got from Amazon. I'll put a link below. Just let it relax. Let it breathe. Like the tension from always having in braids and ponytails. Nope. And twists and whatever style, it puts a lot of stress on the hair. It's just good to kind of let it go and let it relax every now and then. Another really important way I care for my girls' hair is they have like a collection of satin bonnets or scarves and things. I put it on their hair every single night when they're going to bed.
They, I don't know who taught her,
pillowcases,
they did a good job.
Below. I think they were like $6 or $7 on Amazon. Not only is it good for their hair to keep it from breaking and being dry and brittle, it just keeps the moisture in. It also is really good for your face as well. Cotton can strip the hair of its natural oils and really cause it to dry faster. So switching out your kid's pillowcase with a satin or a silk one, and also having a silk or satin head wrap or bonnet is really important to protecting the hair while they sleep.
So
there are a million ways that you can care for your child's hair and to keep it healthy and to make sure that it is always moisturized and well taken care of. You know, there's a lot for me to learn still, but these are the things that I know work for my kids hands down. I feel like these are the super raw, basic maintenance techniques on how to care for a beautiful African-American girl or boy's hair. I'm learning things every single day. Again, I am not an expert. This is not a hair tutorial. I just really wanted to give some knowledge to people that really have no clue what it takes to care for their hair and to maintain it. Like it's so important. You know, if you don't do anything to moisturize or care for, you know, your child or the child you're caring for's hair, it's going to break off.
Yeah.
It's not only will it damage the hair, you know, permanently, it also is going to strip the child of their confidence.
It is.
You know, their hair is their crown.
That is true.
And maintaining it and caring for it appropriately, not only, I cannot even, I'm gonna get emotional thinking about it because I've seen so many babies walking around with their hair matted and not cared for because their caregiver just did not take the time to learn how to properly care for it. So please, if you are unable to, if you are not willing to, please find someone who will. I also want to say that what works for one child will not work for another child. I know I touched bases on this a little bit in the beginning, but I can't just tell you like, hey girl, use this leave-in conditioner, it works wonders, because it may not work for your child like it works for my child.
Yes.
And when you start to detangle a child's hair, you want to make sure that it is fully moisturized and you have the proper tool to detangle without damaging the hair.
Yep.
And start at the end. Start with small, tiny strokes at the end of the hair and work your way up. If you start from the scalp and try to go down, you're not gonna get anywhere. You're gonna damage the hair, you're gonna get frustrated, and it's gonna take you a million years to get the tangles out of the hair, and by the time you're done, half of the hair will be gone.
Let's mine just say doesn't that. Tangle
so
often,
it's so
but
important to start at the end.
I start
of the
from
hair.
My root.
Okay, enough of that. I wanna kind of tell you quickly about what I'm doing to Elia's hair. So I did take it out of a style that I put in it last week. I usually only style her hair every 1 to 2 weeks. Remember, I don't put cornrows in her hair simply because I do not know how to do it. Oh, I've tried okay. And I just can't That's do funny. It.
I can't cornrow that well either.
I can do singles and twists all day. I just can't cornrow. And when she wants it, I have a really good friend of mine do it for her, which lasts like 3 weeks to a month. Maybe I can stretch it if I really oil her scalp well and keep on it. But if I'm just doing twists or one strand braids or whatever, it only lasts 1 to 2 weeks tops. The style that she had before this, I had for 1 week, and I only wash every 2 weeks, and her hair is in such good shape. I didn't need to do like a co-wash this
time. She has the healthiest hair I've seen.
I just needed a little bit of a revamp to get her through to the week. I'm doing a special style next week. So this style I'm hoping that will last maybe 8 to 9 days before she has a special event where I'm going to style it again. But what I did was I gently took out her little poof styles that I had. She had a lot of rubber bands in it. Gently, don't worry, they were not tight. But I usually use like a cuticle remover or a little baby nail clipper and gently clip the rubber bands so that they just naturally fall out of her hair and don't cause any damage. If you try to take a rubber band and just rip it out of her hair, you're gonna rip the hair with it. So I gently just clipped it with the cuticle, or I think this time I couldn't find it.
That's smart.
So I used a little baby nail clipper, clipped it, and it just gently released so there was no damage to the hair. Then I went ahead and parted it and moisturized it with leave-in conditioner. That is my go-to. I use it with everything. I don't really put too much grease in her hair. Only on little stubborn dry areas I will put it, but I try to avoid the scalp. In my little white bottle thing with the squeeze top, that is my little makeshift coconut oil and water mixture.
Did she even got the spray bottle?
That I use on the parts of her
girl.
So only thing is in here is just a little spray detangler and leave-in conditioner and some coconut oil on the scalp. That's it. I do.
Damn, sis!
For our new Hearth and Hand with Magnolia collection, only at Target.
You use a little edge gel around the edges of her hair just to give it a little bit of that clean look. But I really don't use gel too much. And when I do, I just use the Eco Styler.
Ooh,
I know you guys probably saw me using some different
people products. People gonna be mad at that. You know they done canceled that
but
one.
But your girl has learned. I've improved. I've evolved. I've changed. And, you know, the routine has changed. And the products that I use change as well. I did recently, the past 3 or 4 months, start using Carol's Daughter. But I really wanted to use up the rest of my Cantu products before I fully go into the Carol's Daughter because I absolutely love them, but I'm not going to use the new product and it has worked for me thus far. So I'm going to use up these products.
The product I hate Cantu, but I'm going to get to that later.
Never mind, this isn't a hair tutorial. The next hair video that you see, I will be using strictly Carol's Daughter products, which I absolutely love. All right, I've been blabbing way too much. I'm gonna let you guys hear some beats and just enjoy the music and watch me finish up Elia's hair. But one more thing before I go, everyone braids differently. Everyone moisturizes and has their own technique. Everyone puts beads in the hair differently.
That's true.
Everyone has their own style, their own flavor, their own way of doing things. So let's not judge.
I absolutely love this video. It's refreshing to see someone actually trying to learn, okay, trying to be there for their kid, you know, where most people wouldn't even go through the trouble of trying to do that. Like, I have a couple friends that were adopted by white people and they just have relaxers or they wear wigs all the time, and it's like I've never seen their natural hair. And a couple of them have told me, like, yeah, you know, like my mom never knew how to do my hair, so she always sent me to the shop, or blah blah blah, my aunt or whatever didn't know how to do my hair, so she just relaxed it. And it's just like, it really sucks to hear that, because it's like, what the fuck? Like, some people just need to be more patient with their kids. Anyone who has a problem with that video, or any other white people that really have African American or black children and take the time to learn and take care of their kids' hair, you have a fucking problem. I don't think there's anything wrong with this. I really, really like it. I feel like a lot of people sent me this video for malicious intent, And it was just like, what did y'all expect me to say? There's absolutely nothing wrong with it. I think it's incredible. I think it's spectacular. I don't think she did anything wrong. Like she said in the video, everyone does things their own way. If you don't agree with it, that's fine. That's not your fucking kid. That girl's hair is healthy. It's beautiful. And a lot of people that are probably complaining, y'all probably never seen y'all hair. I'm just gonna be real. A lot of the people that like to comment on these things, they're cowards. They're allowed, but they could never show their face and they would never say it to your face. So I personally don't think it's okay to be attacking this woman or anyone else. Just like, I feel like a lot of people love to come for white people that like adopt black kids. You know, they're like, oh my God, you're obsessed with us. Like, why would you do that? And it's like, how many black kids have you adopted? Like, how many black kids have you adopted? Because it sounds like the people that love to complain about shit like this are people that have never stepped foot in an adoption agency or foster cared or fostered any children in their neighborhoods, but they want to complain. Like, at the end of the day, somebody got to do that shit. There's too many kids in the system, okay? White, black, whatever. But there's a lot of black kids in the system. Someone has to love, care, and support for these children. And I love the people out there that don't care what kid they get. They just want a kid to take care of, to love, and to cherish. And that's the most important thing here. Whether you are black and you are adopting an Asian kid, or you are Indian and you're adopting a black kid, whatever, okay? I think it is important just to see that kids need that stable environment and kids need love, period, regardless of their ethnicity and their race. So comment down below, do you think that it is detrimental for someone to be adopted by someone that is not of their race or ethnicity? Because I would love to see the comments on that one. Comment down below. Let me know what you think about this video. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, and do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all.